Ladies and gentlemen, my classical family, it's your boy Gidi back with another reaction. Hope y'all are doing good. I'm doing great. Today we are reacting to a Liszt piece. We haven't done that in a while. And today we are reacting to Dante Symphony by Franz Liszt. Let me see who performed it. So it's conducted by Daniel Barenboim with the Berliner Philharmonica. So yeah, hope y'all enjoy the reaction. Hope I enjoy it too, obviously. Let's go.
Sorry.
a bit surprised, I have to say, but we'll talk at the end. Getting some quietness. I don't think that's gonna last though. Oh. Am I wrong?
Thank you.
Always sounds so good. No matter in what kind of piece it's played in. Closing my eyes and listening to a piece always, for some reason, helps me immerse into the piece even much more. So I'm not sleeping. Like this part. Why was this first movement so heavy and so loud? Like, we are listening to Liszt, right? So in the beginning, I observed something. I wanted to mention it, but I didn't, because this piece reminds me of this man. So I don't know what the story behind it is. Maybe I didn't read it. Let's see. A Symphony to Dante's Divine Comedy, or simply Dante's Symphony, is a program symphony written in the high romantic style. It is based on Dante Alighieri's journey through hell and purgatory as depicted in the Divine Comedy. It was premiered in Dresden in November 1857 with Liszt himself conducting, and was unofficially dedicated to the composer friend and future son-in-law Richard Wagner. It makes sense. Yesterday I was doing a live stream for my Patreon members, and somebody requested a piece from Wagner. And one thing that I've observed with Wagner is he's very loud. So whenever I press on play, if it's a Wagner piece, I expect it to be very loud. And so when I read something about, I saw Wagner's name, but I didn't really pay attention to it. But then the piece started playing and it reminded me of him, because I'm always saying Wagner is very loud. But then I looked at the title, it says Liszt. So I was kind of confused what is going on. So it kind of makes sense. I don't know. I mean, you guys can pause it and read the rest, but it's still very interesting, especially so dedicated. Okay, unofficially dedicated to the composer's friend. So, yeah, Richard Wagner. So to his friend Richard Wagner and future son-in-law. Wow. I mean, I guess, yeah, very interesting. And I don't know. Maybe you guys can let me know down in the comments, but very heavy and very loud first movement. Not something I was expecting to hear from Liszt. But yeah, still kind of interesting to know like the backstory, a little bit of the backstory behind this piece. Let's continue. Yeah. Exactly. Interesting. Interesting. Maybe I gotta move, no, to this side or this side? This side a little bit. Okay. Second movement. me Google if this piece is like a play, like a theater play or something. So I was just inspired by. I'm reading what the story is about. If y'all can see it. It's in German, by the way. Sorry. It's Paradiso, Magnificat, okay. It got me there. Third one. Thank you. That's the third one. Oh, it's a good transition. I like this final movement. This it sounds angelic. I can't lie. I like it. Wow. Yeah, I have to say, first of all, I wasn't expecting the whole symphony to sound like this. I think my relationship with Liszt started off with fast-paced and complicated pieces that also sound good. I know that I do often say this when I'm talking about Liszt, but yeah, that's how how I got to know Liszt. So listening to something that sounds very different makes me very impressed, and it just makes me even respect him as a composer even more. You can tell he was a very talented composer. And I don't know what age he was when he composed this, but even being inspired by a poem and then creating a whole symphony out of it, it's impressive. And you can tell within the movements that sometimes when maybe there's a climax in the poem or in the story, you can tell how the piece kinda also highlights the climax, like in its own way. You can kind of make a movie in your head. I think you should read the poem before, though. I was going through it. It's very long, so obviously I didn't read the whole thing, but it seems very interesting. So for the last movement, a short paragraph that I can read to y'all is the Divine Comedy. So that's the poem that inspired this piece. The Divine Comedy finishes with Dante seeing the Triune God in a flash of understanding that he cannot express. Dante finally understands the mystery of Christ's divinity and humanity, and his soul becomes aligned with God's love. That's what I'm talking about when I say the piece highlights the story kind of good. Like, if you had read this beforehand and you listened to the last movement, it kind of makes sense. It's very difficult to understand, but I hope y'all understand what I'm trying to say. But overall, I'll put like the link of the poem down in the description. Very interesting. Enjoyed it. I have to say, the first movement, wasn't expecting it, but I really enjoyed it, especially because it reminded me of Wagner. And also, it did say that unofficially, it was dedicated to him. So also very interesting to know. The second movement, it was a bit difficult to sit through the second movement, maybe because it was a bit slower than the first movement. Not a bit, it was really slow. But the last movement, I enjoyed that. There were some voices to be heard, and I always enjoy voices or singing in classical music, so that's always a plus for me. But yeah, classical fam, let me know down in the comments how you feel about this piece. Do you like it? Do you enjoy it? Do you not? Give me your opinions down in the comments. And if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. It's been your boy Giddy. I'm gonna catch you on the next one. Bye. Searching. I just wanna talk to you. I just wanna talk to you.